thought or discussion about like female beauty. I don't care if we're talking about relaxing beauty standards, expanding beauty standards. You can be beautiful even if you look like that. Like, I'm literally done. This man is considered one of the greatest living writers in the world. This man is one of the most genius directors. This man ran Russia and all its bitches. My utility does not come from my appearance. I am not an aesthetic object. I am a subject. I am a human being. Men are allowed to look like whatever and still be considered worthwhile, dynamic, interesting. I simply cannot have these discussions about who's pretty anymore. I'm so tired. I have stuff to do. I have things I would like to accomplish in this life. This is taking up too much of my time and energy, and it has for the past like 22 years. And like, I'm realizing that we cannot wait for society to like come together and be like, you know what, it's okay if you're an ugly woman. They're never gonna say that. Like, it's so hard to put down the need to be beautiful, but we just have to do it, because they're never going to free us. Must be dramatic, but we must free ourselves, ladies.
You are being very dramatic. You're trying to free yourselves of any conversation around beauty whatsoever. You seem very agitated about something, and I feel like the root problem is maybe not beauty standards, but something else going on in your life. I don't know. This reminds me of a conversation my mom and I had, actually many conversations, because my mom was so adamant about like not talking about my looks. She always emphasized intelligence and your values, to the point that like I was never called a princess, I was never babied, I was never like told that I looked cute or pretty or anything like that. Like, it was solely focused on my
internal,
my intelligence. I never even thought of myself
internal
as like
qualities,
looking pretty or whatever. I remember being in the car with her, and I cared so little that like at 15 years old she had to look at me and be like, can you please take care of yourself? It wasn't that I like wasn't showering, taking care of myself, it was just I simply did not care. I would be in mega baggy jeans, huge Doc Martens, oversized sweatshirts, did not put on a lick of makeup, and she was like, oh my god, you look like a bush lesbian. But not even like a cool one. It's just like, you do not care. And we had this whole conversation where she was like, it is okay to like embrace that feminine side. It is okay to be like, I want to look nice. I want to take care of myself. You don't have to do that for a guy. It's just like taking care of yourself so that what you are presented to the outside world is something that is nice to look at, so that you feel good about it. And that was like such a revelation for me. I was like, oh my god, the mother that never acknowledged what I look like is telling me I can do this. But it just was a complete transformation for me. And basically what I was saying in that story is, it's okay to want to present yourself in a nice way to the world.
Facts.
That is not a bad thing.
Nope.
I don't agree that every woman needs to fit into one cookie cutter like type of look, body size, whatever. I think we all should be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't agree that we need to fit into like a model beauty standard. But presenting yourself to the world with like elegance and being cleaned up and being presentable, that's not a bad thing. And it's not some like deep issue that you need to be like hyperventilating about on TikTok. There are plenty of women who are not conventionally attractive who are incredibly successful. You just chose to highlight some of the men that would fit into that category. Like, I think you're making a cupcake out of a crumb here.
Yesterday, one of my friends said that 2023 goals or New Year's resolutions are capitalistic BS that pushes us into productivity when we're supposed to be hibernating during the winter season.
That's not
what you're talking about. I agree, but I think it's really important to know yourself so that you can distinguish what is the goal that you just want to do because you want to be productive for productive sake, or what actually helps you as a person.
You know, I watch these videos sometimes and I am reminded how differently I view the world than these people. Like, on a basic level, like when it comes to like my premises and my principles, I do value productivity over everything. I'm not trying to like work for the man, but I believe that in order to have a fulfilled life, I need to be contributing something to society, and I need to be constantly, you know, finding value in what I'm putting out in the world, whether it's my work, like a, you know, for-profit work, or whether it's charitable or whatever. Like, when I was at Trader Joe's, I still had to find value and fulfillment in putting lettuce up on shelves because that is how I was getting paid. And it felt good. I didn't hate that job. I actually loved that job because I was able to connect with people, make people's day. I was able to provide a service to people. I love productivity. It's not a bad thing. And I watch these videos where they're like, I can't believe you're just doing that for the sake of productivity. You should just be hibernating and relaxing. Like, that is, I cannot do that. I'm so bad at relaxing. Maybe that's like a personal thing I need to work on, because relaxing is good sometimes.
Yeah,
but
it's a balance. There has to be a balance, you know what I mean? Like Wellness Mogul said, a lot of people are working themselves to death. You don't want to do that. There has to be a balance. The grind is important. The productivity is important, but you got to breaks are important. Self-care is important. They're both important, man. So, yeah, man. Yeah, bro. Don't mess up your physical. Don't mess up your physical health. You know what I mean? Like, definitely grind. The productivity is important, but don't work yourself to death. Yeah, man. Yeah.
Productivity, you should just be hibernating and relaxing. Like, that is, I cannot do that. I'm so bad at relaxing. Maybe that's like a personal thing I need to work on, because relaxing is good sometimes. But it's like, at the very basic principles of how I move through the world and what I value, it is so vastly different. I think it's important to remember that when watching these videos, because if we look at all these people and it's like, oh my god, why do I think so differently? Like, why are they so crazy? It's because we operate from totally different foundations.
I don't want to say goals that can be like career goals.
I'll be back, y'all.